In today's video, we're going to talk about using ChatGPT to aid coding. So ChatGPT aided coding refers to the practice of leveraging the ChatGPT language model to assist with various aspects of software development and coding tasks. This involves using ChatGPT to generate code snippets, explain complex programming concepts, debug code, provide recommendations for best practices, and even help with testing and documentation. The goal of ChatGPT-aided coding is to enhance productivity, improve code quality, and simplify the development process for programmers of all skill levels. Code generation. So ChatGPT can generate code snippets based on user prompts. This can range from simple functions to more complex algorithms depending on the user's request and specificity of the instructions provided. You can also use ChatGPT for code explanation and learning. It helps in understanding code by explaining programming concepts, language syntax, and the functionality of code snippets. This is particularly useful for beginners or developers working with unfamiliar languages or frameworks. You can also use ChatGPT for debugging assistance. ChatGPT can assist in identifying errors or bugs in code by analyzing error messages or reviewing code snippets. It can suggest potential fixes or point out where things might be going wrong. Some other things you can use with ChatGPT is best practices and recommendations. It can offer advice on coding best practices, design patterns, and performance optimization techniques. This guidance helps ensure that the code is not only functional, but also efficient, maintainable, and scalable. You can also use ChatGPT to create test cases and scenario generation. In the context of software testing, ChatGPT can help generate test cases and scenarios, including providing test data sets, which are crucial for ensuring the application behaves as expected under various conditions. And finally, you can use ChatGPT for documentation and comments. For example, you can generate documentation or comments for code to make it more understandable and maintainable is another area that you can use. And so those are some basic things that you can do with ChatGPT, but there are much more things you can do, and we're just going to be covering those things that we mentioned. But first, in order for ChatGPT to aid Selenium coding, you have to have Selenium Java installed on your computer. After you do that, make sure you can download and install the IntelliJ IDE. And this is from JetBrains. So if you don't have it already, just go to JetBrains website and search up IntelliJ and install it for your system configurations, because we'll be using IntelliJ in our project today. Next, what we're going to be doing is we're going to install ChatGPT plugins. And this is why we need IntelliJ IDE, because inside the IntelliJ IDE, we're going to install a ChatGPT plugin called EasyCode. And we'll walk you through the steps on how to do this later, but in general, you can just go to your file settings and the plugins, and then you can search for the ChatGPT plugin. And also, you can view your different plugins by going to View, Tools, Windows, and then ChatGPT to see your plugin. And then, because ChatGPT might not be accessible to everybody, sometimes you might have to sign in to your ChatGPT account to see if it's to get everything configured properly. Okay, so now I'm going to show you how you can use ChatGPT in your own project for Selenium Java. So the first thing I have here is I have my IntelliJ IDE open. And so I'm first going to show you how you can get the plugin for ChatGPT. So I have it right here. But for those that don't have it already, you just go to File, and then you'll go to Settings, and then you'll go to Plugin right here, and you can just search up ChatGPT. So I have it right here, and it's ChatGPT-EasyCode. And since I already have it installed, this says Disable. But for you that don't have it installed, you can just click Install, and this should work. There are other ChatGPT ones as well. These other plugins, I haven't tried it personally myself because some of them require you to pay some sort of monetary value. But once you have this ChatGPT plugin installed, you can go ahead and close this. And then you can go to your View. You can go to your Tools window. And then you can click on ChatGPT and it'll open up this ChatGPT here. So the first time you open it up, it'll usually ask you to sign into your ChatGPT account. Since I've already signed in, it's not asking me to do that. Another thing is note that on this ChatGPT account, I've actually paid for GPT-4 and you might only have GPT-3.5, but all of it should have the same functionality. So I'm going to stay at the easy code window right here. And before I show you how I can use ChatGPT, I just want to show you how I set up this project. So first thing I did to set up this project is I'm using JUnit in my main test folder. So under my project, my test one, I created a test folder, and then under Java, I created test one. And in this test folder, I created a before test and after, and test and after, which is the standard format for a JUnit project. Note that because I'm using, for example, Selenium Java, JUnit, and all those different type of packages, I'm going to have to update my pom.xml file like you always do. And so, for example, in here, I have my pom.xml commands for Selenium Java, JUnit. I also have it for some other things in here as well. But for those that are not familiar how to do this, I would suggest you go to the Maven website and they have these commands that you can just paste into your pom.xml file and it'll basically allow you to configure your space and build your project. Okay, so now that we're done with setting up all those things, we can go back to our test project right here. And then, so for this test project, I basically created some general framework of it. So I have the setup function, I have the WE function, the ChatGPT function, and the teardown function. And what I want to do is I want ChatGPT to write this for me. So I have some basic things right here. Let me show you how we can do this. So first, I'm going to delete all the code that we have. And then for those that I've commented out, that will basically serve as a reference to see if we've done the right thing. So the first thing we want to do is we want to work in the setup function. And in the setup function, the main thing we want to do is we want to set up the Chrome driver so that later on we can use the Chrome driver to access various different websites. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to highlight this commented line right here. I'm going to right click. I'm going to click Ask GPT. But before I do that, I want you to note that right here under Easy Code tab, there's a Ask Codebase. If this is not already checked, make sure you have it checked because if you don't have it checked, then it won't give you code in response. So again, I'm going to highlight this. I'm going to right click. I'm going to say Ask GPT, and I'm going to write code. That's what I'm going to say. I'm going to press Enter. And now it'll basically write some code for us. And so for this right here, we see that it's giving us some general things. And again, this is going to require a little bit of knowledge of Selenium and Java, but the purpose of this is just to speed up. It's not to replace the coding process, but just so that you don't have to write everything by yourself and you don't have to know all the syntax by yourself. But I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to copy what they have here. I'm not going to copy driver quit because that's something that you typically include in the end of your project. So we'll include that in our teardown. But I'm going to copy what I have here and I'm going to paste this. And I paste it over. So now we see that they have system.setProperty, and you're setting the property to webdriver.chrome. And this is not ideal. You don't use this in the most recent versions of Selenium. And so I'm gonna go ahead and delete this actually. So I know that it's not ideal because of my knowledge of Selenium. So I'm gonna delete that. We won't need that. And then another thing is in this project already, we created a variable webdriver driver inside the scope of the class. So within this function, we don't actually have to do this. So we can just say the driver, we'll delete the web driver part, and we'll just do driver is equal to new Chrome driver. And now this should be able to open a Chrome driver. And we don't have anything else in here. So I can actually go ahead and I can test this. So I'll just go here. And then I'll basically just run this. And what it should do is it should just open a Chrome driver for us. And that's it. And actually, it does. So it opens a Chrome driver and it passes. So it says the test pass. So go ahead and close this. Now we can move on into the test function that we will have. So under the test function, what we want to do is we want to go to this URL as the first step. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to highlight this again, right click, and I'm going to tell it to write code again. And this time we'll let it some time. So if we see on this window right here, it has what we specified earlier. So it has the web driver, Chrome driver, but it also has this line right here, which is really what we're interested in. So I'm going to go ahead and copy that. Copy that, and I'm going to paste it under here. And we see it says driver.get idiom lucid golf, and that's the exact same as what we had earlier that we commented out, so we know that it's right. I'm not going to test this yet because we already know it's right, but I'm actually going to copy and paste this, copy this one, and then right click again and say write code again, and I'm going to tell it to search for Tiger A on the website. So we see again it generates some new code. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to copy all of this, and I'm actually going to paste under here. And so there's a few things we have to note. The first thing is right here, it doesn't know the attribute or the locator for the place that we want to search the input. And so it just uses search, but we know that it's the locator is actually search string for the name. And how do we know this? Well, again, we can always go to our website right here. So this is our website. We can right click the element and then we can click inspect. And we see that the name is search string right here. So go ahead and close that. So we're replacing it with search string right here. And then it says sending keys Tiger A, and then it's using return. Instead, earlier before what we had was we actually located the button and did send keys return, but this should work as well. So if I go ahead and I right click this and let's see if it works. Give it some time to run. And basically it opened up this browser right here. It searched up Tiger A, it found the golf course, and we see that the test passed. So yeah, so ChatGPT, it wrote everything we wanted it to write. Although it's not perfect, but it did speed up the process by a lot more. So after you finish that, I'm going to show you something else you can do with ChatGPT. So I'm actually going to show you an old project that we have right here. And the first thing I'm going to do is, for example, I'm going to go to this this class right here. And I'm just going to copy, or maybe I'll go to another one. I'll go to the login one right here. And I'll go to this one right here. We know that what it does is it logs in. And I'll basically ask, what does this function do? And basically, this code, ChatGPT will tell you exactly what this function does. For example, clicks on a link with the text login, enters the email address, enters the password, and then clicks login. So we know that this is a very simple example, but we just see the power of what ChatGPT can do with more complex functions. There's some other things you can do as well. For example, with ChatGPT, if I go ahead and hover this and right click this, there's actually, you can actually refactor the code. So basically what this means is ChatGPT will fix up your code if it's a little bit messy and make it into a more readable and more more presentable format. And this is really good if you were just typing some draft code and you just had your ideas all over the place, but you wanted to clean it up afterwards. You can also use ChatGPT to write unit tests, so to test your code. And these are all things that you can explore on your own time. Or you can use custom prompts right here. For example, you can tell it to do some other things, maybe create documentations and so on. But in the end, yeah, this is what ChatGPT can now do. And this is what people have been using ChatGPT for, to basically aid themselves into creating their own projects. In today's video, we showed an application of ChatGPT in creating your own Selenium Java automation testing project. If you found this video interesting or helpful, please give this video a like and follow our channel. And yeah, we look forward to seeing you next time. Thank you.